Hi, my name's Rosalind Bell and welcome to my YouTube channel. My channel is all about the digital world and social media. So if you want to learn new skills, then you're in the right place. Today's video is called How to Use Apple Notes. Apple Notes is an application on your iPhone and it's basically just like having a pad and paper with you all the time. You can jot down whenever you need to make a note of something. I'm going to show you how to use it so you can implement it into your everyday life. Even if you're just going shopping and you just want to make a quick note that you need to get something quickly at the shops whilst you're out. So let's get into the application. So from our home screen, we're going to go into the Notes app. So if we click that, it will take us into our folders. I'm going to click on the iCloud Notes. That will take me into the notes for that folder. And then to start a new note, I'm going to click on the bottom right, the little pen in the square. That will give me a blank sheet to write a new note. So from my blank screen, I'm just going to start typing. I'm just typing an example here of a quick shopping list. I'll just get that up on the screen. And then when that's done, I'm going to go back and click on the B for bread. I'm going to select the whole little list. Once it's selected, drag the second circle down until you've got the whole list selected, and then you can click on the plus sign with a tick in it and it will give it to you in some bullets. Now if I wanted to use conventional bullet points, I just click on the A and it brings up these options below. So I can change it to number them, give them bullet points, dashes, I can indent it and do all sorts of things from that tab there. Now if I click on that little grid next to the A, it puts me in a table. Now if I hold that grid down, it gives me options of things I can do with the table. But I'm just going to start typing in a few characters here to fill these four cells. And now you notice these three little dots next to the three. If I pick those up, put my finger on them and click, and I can drag up that whole line to bring it above the one above it. And then I can do the same with the column. I can pick up those three dots and move the column over to the other side. So down at the bottom in the middle, there's a plus sign in a circle. If I click on that, it gives me varying different options now at what I can do with my note. So I can scan a document in, I can take a picture, use one of my own pictures, I can draw. So I'm actually going to click on scan a document here. That will now take me into the camera and I can see what I actually want to take a copy of. I want to scan. And here it's asking me to position the document where I want to take the picture. At the top right of the screen it says auto, and I'm going to click on that and change it to manual. That will let me manipulate the picture to where I want it to be. So now I get these corners that appear that I can click on and drag and get the position exactly how I want it on the screen. And once I've done that at the bottom, I'm going to keep the scan as opposed to retake it if I didn't like it. So as soon as I click on keep scan, it will take it and put it into the bottom left hand corner of my screen, and then I can click on the save button, where it will take the picture, take the scan, and put it straight into my notes. It's a very similar process if you want to take a picture. Hit the plus sign again and go back and select take a picture. Take the photo, and once you've done that, it will ask you if you want to use the photo. Just click use and it will pop it into your notes. So the icon to the right of the plus sign at the bottom is your freehand drawing tool, and this will bring you up your pens and pencils and eraser. So if you clicked on one of the pens to use, you can amend the thickness of the pen it's going to write with, and you can rub out anything using the eraser. Also, using the lasso tool, which is the circle, it will actually pick up anything that you've drawn and delete the whole lot all in one go. There's also a colour wheel, the black in the circle. If you click on that, that will give you a colour palette and you'll be able to change the colour of the implement that you want to use. At the top right, you've got three more options and three more buttons. If you click on the middle option with the upward facing arrow, you'll get these options on screen now. The usual Apple options, you can message someone, the note, email it to someone, or you can click on lock with a password. If you click on that, you can actually save each note individually, password secured. Now the icon at the top right, which looks like it's a person in a circle, if you click on that, it will let you invite other people to see your note. It will give you the options on how you can invite them in to view this note, and they'll be able to make any amendments. But bearing in mind, everyone needs to be on iCloud to do this. If we go back to our folders now and look at our notes, we'll see the one that we made, the shopping list, now has a picture next to it. Because we actually took a photo and we embedded it in the note, it actually shows up on that screen, which can be very handy when you've got 20 or 30 notes and you quickly want to find the one you're looking for and you're scrolling up and down. Now, if we look at that little icon in the bottom left, looks like four boxes stacked together. If we click on that, that will show us all the attachments that we've got in our notes. So if there's a particular one that we're looking for, we can just click on it and we can use it in another application. As with all Apple applications, you can amend the settings. So we're going to go into Utilities and Settings and find the Notes app. So click on that and that will let you personalise how you view your Notes app. Lines and grids here is quite a good one. If you do lots of drawing and writing on your notes pad, you might permanently want to change the template from a blank screen to a lined screen. And this is how you can do it. So every time you go into the app, it will bring you up a lined sheet of paper. There are varying other different personalizations you can do here, so just go ahead and make the changes. So now you have the skills to use your Notes application on your iPhone. So I hope you have fun using it. Please leave me any comments down below, any questions or queries you have for me, and I shall get back to you as soon as I can. Also, please subscribe to my channel. I'd love to have you subscribe. And click the notification bell so you receive an email when I've uploaded another video. Thank you for watching, and until next time, bye bye.